All right. So how was your week? I hope everyone is healthy and safe and staying home. I read some numbers on the real estate market this week you might find interesting. We had 29 new listings come on the market in Elk Grove last week. We had 29 of those listings go pending. So it wasn't necessarily the original 29 that went on the market that went pending, but 29 went on the market and 29 came right back off. We closed 16 deals. So 16 deals officially closed escrow. Now, the thing that changed this week is the multiple offer situation. Last week, we saw 58% of the sellers that received offers got multiple offers. This week, that number has actually reduced dramatically. We have seen that number. It came in this week at 27%. So of those sellers that received offers, 27% of them received multiple offers, each one of them receiving on average around three and a half offers each. So that's way down from last week. I have asked around the office and it seems like it's getting easier to get buyers into contract, which is good news. I did actually run some March numbers. Now, let me just tell you really quick about the market and how it typically works in Elk Grove. We normally see in around March an uptick in listings coming on the market, and we tend to peak out somewhere around July or August with the amount of home sales that happen. We went into this year with a lot less inventory than we had last year. So I ran some numbers from March of last year comparing to March of this year, and we are actually down 37%. Our inventory is reduced by 37% since this time last year. So I would assume that is why all of the multiple offers are occurring, because we have very low inventory. We still have super high demand. We have decent interest rates. I actually heard of a client that got locked in around just under 3.5%, which is stellar. And so I think that is definitely driving the market right now. One thing I want you to keep in mind is, if you're a buyer, the guidelines are changing for getting loans. That's the reality of it is, the reality, okay? So we have noticed that down payment assistance programs are still available. Some people are not able to offer them, but there still are programs available. We've noticed that they've increased the credit score requirements. So almost a 40-point increase in FICO score in order to qualify now. That means you have to have better credit in order to get the loan. They also lowered their debt to income ratio. So you can't have as much debt as you had before and qualify for the same amount. It's kind of a big deal if you're on the edge. If you're one of those buyers that are just trying to squeak into your price range, you really want to take it seriously as far as considering getting out there and purchasing a home now. Yes, I understand this can be scary and we're in uncharted territory. We also don't want you to miss the opportunity to purchase a home because the guidelines have changed on us and now you no longer qualify. So it may or may not impact you, but if you're on the edge with your numbers, it probably will. So why don't you give me a call? We'll run your numbers. We'll have you talk to a loan officer and we'll figure out what your opportunity is to win right now. Sellers, you still have the upper hand because there's only 1.3 months worth of inventory for the month of March in our market, which means that a normal market is around 4 to 5 months worth of inventory, where both buyer and seller have the same advantage. And you definitely still have the upper hand in that there's just not enough homes to go around based on the demand. So that's the update for the week. Hopefully this went live. If not, I will post it later and figure out what my technology challenges are. But I just wanted to make sure that we get you the information that you need so that you can make the best decisions possible for you and your family. All right. Well, thanks for joining me again, and I will see you next week.